Today we're gonna have a look at a pair of trail running shoes from Adidas. Hello guys and welcome back for another review. As mentioned before, today we're gonna have a look at a trail running shoe from Adidas. So let's go ahead and take them out of the box. Okay guys, so today we're gonna have a look at this Terrex 2 Ultra Primeblue. So this color combination got released just a few days ago in UK for a retail price of £160. But I need to add that this specific model, it's actually around for a year now and nothing actually changed, but from time to time, as you know, Adidas and major brands are just releasing new color combination, and this one will be one of them. So as the name would suggest, this contains some recycled materials which we know that Adidas is using for some time now. So as you can see, we have a prime knit for the upper, and we also have some protective abrasive material at the back and also at the front. And of course, as you can see very clearly, we have a boost midsole, which of course will make this shoe very comfortable. So let's go ahead and see what materials we actually have on this one. So as you can see, starting here at the front, we have this rubberized material, which is actually in the two different layers. As you can see, underneath we have a thicker one, and then we have just a thinner one at the top, which covers slightly more than the one underneath it. So towards the lacing system, you can see that we have this prime knit in this multicolors, which will be in this cream, gray, black, and some brown as well. So this one is actually quite stretchy, as you can see here. It's flexing a lot, but I need to admit that this one is actually quite thick, so it's not gonna be as breathable as you would expect from an Ultra Boost 20 or 21. But this, as this being a trail shoe, it needs to be slightly more thicker, so it will protect you from whatever comes in your way. As we go to the lacing system, we don't have any cage, but we have this very nice rubberized material, which actually acts like loopholes for this prime knit. As you can see, these shoelaces are trim, which they feel that they are a bit longer than usual, but not everyone will have a problem with this one. And as this is a sock type shoe, you can see that we have this very stretchable material here, which I need to admit that for the first few uses, it was a bit hard to put them on. But in time, this will give. So as you can see here under these laces, we have a slightly different pattern for this prime knit. And just on top of it, we have this stripe, which actually has a bit of padding. So I guess when you're gonna tighten your shoelaces, this one will actually give you a bit of protection. Also, just before these stripes, you can see that we have some reinforcement here on the lateral and also on the medial side. So we have this double stitching in this gray color. And then as we pass them, you can see that we have these three stripes in this brown color, which I think they are just painted over. Also, this stripe that I've mentioned earlier has the 320 numbering on it, which actually represents the actual weight of this shoe, which is 320 grams. As we go here to the ankle section, we have this pull tab in this gray color, where you actually can see the lettering saying Primeblue. And also we have this rubberized material, which is slightly abrasive. and it's in this solid red color, and you also have the Adidas and Terrex logos here imprinted. And as we go towards the midsole, you can see that we have a rubber support, and as you can see we have here 23/29, which will represent the actual height of this midsole. This one will actually act as a bit of support for the back of the shoe. And now we're gonna go to this white Boost midsole, which is very comfortable, and it's really giving a nice ride. As you know, going to the trails, you're not gonna have a smooth ride, but having this Ultra Boost really helps you out. But being in this white color, for sure it will get dirty in no time. And then we're gonna finish with this rubber Continental outsole, which is in this very nice pattern in this cream and brown. You can see also that we have here in the middle the Adidas and the Continental logos. And as you can see, we have a very nice and high grip, so for sure this one will be very useful when actually trying to get a grip on the trails. And overall, this one, in my opinion, looks very nice. It's nothing spectacular, I mean, it's just a trail shoe. But I really feel that this one is actually a very good competitor for the Wildhorse, at least. Of course, it's gonna be slightly more expensive. At the price of £160, it's gonna be at least 20% over the Nike models, which they are usually around 115-130, but I feel that the actual materials used on the Adidas and Terrex, they are a bit more premium, and they give more support. So inside of the shoe we're gonna have this solar red sole, which is made out of foam, but I really need to admit that I was expecting it to be slightly more squishier than this one. Usually on the Ultra Boost you get them more squishier. Also, as you go inside here at the back of the heel section, we have some padding, which I really felt that kept my foot in place just fine. But this lining is actually made out of some felt material, which we also have it inside of the shoe. So underneath this prime knit, you can actually see that we have a lot of felt material. It's actually making my foot a bit hot, so I guess after wearing it for a few hours, it's not gonna be as comfortable, it's gonna be a bit sweaty inside. But in the same time, you'll need some protection. You cannot just have this prime knit, so I guess that's why they decided to use this felt material. But yeah, for sure you need to keep in mind that your foot will get hot quite easily. As in for the actual sizing, I went with my true to size, and I felt that it's a good fit. But I need to admit that if you have wider feet than normal, you should go with a half size up. And overall, I need to admit that even though it's slightly more expensive than the Nike ones, this one is definitely more comfortable, and the materials are, I guess, a bit better. And of course, you can also choose from the other three color combinations that you can actually find at this moment for this model. So guys, yeah, this was my unboxing and reviewing of this Terrex 2 Ultra Primeblue in this cream color. I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel. And as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching.